Good morning. Today we celebrate the feast of Saint Scholastica, Virgin. She died in 543 at Monte Cassino. She was the twin sister of Saint Benedict, eventually interred in the same grave with her brother. Most of what we know of Scholastica comes from the dialogues of Saint Gregory the Great, who wrote, "So death did not separate the bodies of these two, whose minds had ever been united in the Lord." She's invoked against storms. She's the patroness, of course, of the Benedictine nunneries. Here is a wise virgin from among the numbers of the prudent, who went forth with lighted lamp to meet Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd, leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. As we celebrate anew the memorial of the Virgin Saint Scholastica, we pray, O Lord, that following her example we may serve you with pure love and happily receive what comes from loving you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Take send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth.
Bless the Lord, my soul.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus summoned the crowd again and said to them, "Hear me, all of you, and understand. Nothing that enters one from outside can defile that person, but the things that come out from within are what defile." When he got home away from the crowd, his disciples questioned him about the parable. He said to them, "Are even you likewise without understanding? Do you not realize that everything that goes into a person from outside cannot defile, since it enters not the heart, but the stomach, and passes out into the latrine?" Thus he declared all foods clean. But what comes out of the man, that is what defiles him. From within the man, from his heart, come evil thoughts: unchastity, theft, murder, adultery, greed, malice, deceit, licentiousness, envy, blasphemy, arrogance, folly. All these evils come from within, and they defile. The Gospel of the Lord. From within the man, from his heart, come evil thoughts. So what is Jesus telling us here? Whatever our heart is in love with gives rise to our thoughts and these passions that come out of us. And so if we're given to malice of various kinds and bitterness and anger and all of this, we know where our heart is. For instance, if we watch the news too much and fall in love with our attachment to what the news represents, then we're going to be bitter and mean and nasty and all of that kind of thing. If our heart loves our own passions and we're hooked on those kinds of things, then those thoughts are going to come out of us, and not only the thoughts, but the actions that go with them. It's an interesting thing to dwell on for our own spirituality. If we're in love with the Lord, and that occupies our heart, and if we're in love with the goodness in people that are close to us, we love them for the goodness in them, then what's going to come forth from us is goodness and peace and joy and all of those things that we should have as Christians. And sometimes we get tempted in our thoughts. We're not responsible for all of those, because the devil inserts a lot of thoughts in our mind too. And we can get hooked on that and fall in love with the thoughts he puts in our mind about our past sins, about the sins of others, and it gives rise to evil thoughts and to evil attitudes in us. And so in spiritual direction, we help people to recognize these thoughts that are coming and where they're coming from. And the saints tell us that the thoughts, particularly the ones from the devil, you cannot fight those. You're going to lose every time. But what we can do is ignore them. If we notice we're having those thoughts, we can gently get our mind on something else. We can shift the attention of our heart to the love we have for God or for some other human being that shows a lot of goodness. And we get rid of those temptations. They go away, and the devil goes away only when we ignore him. The more we pay attention to him, the more he's got us. You're not going to do battle with the devil and win. Trusting in our Lord who created us, we bring our prayers before him. That the Church may continue to be sanctified and strengthened through the transforming grace of God, let us pray to the Lord. That the Lord may look graciously upon all who desire and strive for purity of heart for the sake of their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. That all who have experienced violence or hatred of any kind may be consoled by the peace and healing of Christ, we pray to the Lord. That the hearts of those of us gathered here may be purified from every evil, let us pray to the Lord. That all who have died may live forever in God's presence, let us pray to the Lord. We pray again this morning for all of the sick and the homebound in our parish, all of those who are in distress, and all of those who are sorely tempted to discouragement and despair. That God be with them and give them consolation and peace through their dwelling on his love for them. We pray to the Lord. And we pray this morning again that God heal our world from its godlessness and bring us together in peace and cooperation, we pray to the Lord. We pray for all of our youth, that they discover the source of goodness and peace in their hearts, in the love they have for Christ. We pray to the Lord. And we offer this Mass this morning especially for Ed and Minnie Brown and Benny Schulte. We pray to the Lord. And God of all creation, we thank you for the gift of life and everything that sustains us. Hear and answer our prayers this day, according to your will, through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, which earth has given in human hands and made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we proclaim your wonders, O Lord, in the Virgin Blessed Scholastica, we humbly implore your majesty that as her merits are pleasing to you, so too our beautiful service may find favor in your sight, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gerald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be. There is one thing I ask of the Lord, only this do I seek, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. Let us pray. Renewed by partaking of this divine gift, we pray, O Lord our God, that by the example of the Blessed Scholastica, bearing in our body the death of Jesus, we may strive to hold fast to you alone. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying God with your lives. Our prayer to Saint Michael.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly.